I'm expanding on the right side. You guys might further ahead than
rest. Their main is flow control and their.
I'll go Gorge to make it fair. It's not fair if I'm running around.
That's probably true.
Can I expand to smell the tunnel there?
Yeah, dude.
Just wanna check.
Just start your sys chain, you know, and see what happens. Bring your drifter to a turbine. I think you can be overly aggressive because they don't have a whole lot of high skilled players on their team.
Yep.
Smelting's fine.
Just don't be super aggressive like that one guy did. He dropped a hive without telling anyone. Marines walked in and killed it, and everyone's like, "Why did you do that?" He goes, "I don't know."
Yeah, it'll be fine. With the teams we have, you know. We're gonna have a huge res flow here because they're not gonna attack our Gs. They're not. It's not that aggressive. Tunnel the smelting. Make sure you upgrade the tunnel. Click on it and press D.
Oh, thank you for that.
Yeah, upgrade it to infest the tunnel. And then put a frag next to it. Frag. Usually, like 99% of the time, that's all you need. Upgrade the tunnel and a frag. That's it. Maybe a whip. Depends on what room it is, what map, what situation. Usually it's just upgrade. Correct. And if you wanted to have extra health, like if it's a real emergency, you use a mist on the ground near it and it'll increase the maturity so that it has more health.
What is mist?
Nutrient mist is what you use to like speed up, like when someone's in an egg, like say they're going fade or whatever, it cuts the time in half or something like that. Nutrient mist also increases the maturity of structures. So you can put it anywhere you have infestation. And when you build a new structure, it has zero maturity. When you drop the mist on it, it costs 2 resources. And then over a period of, I don't know, 5 seconds or something like that, the rate at which the maturity increases is faster. Once it gets to 100% maturity, it has all the hit points that it could have. So your hit points of a structure is not met. There's more hit points than when it first starts. It has the least amount of hit points it can have.
Okay.
So once it gets up to full maturity, if you click on it, it'll say maturity percentage or whatever. It automatically starts building maturity by itself. When you first drop the structure, it starts gaining maturity even before it's finished being built. But if you drop a nutrient mist on it, it gains maturity and then gains health faster. So if you think they're going to rush the tunnel or something like that, you can stay alive. And gain the maturity by dropping mist on it.
Yeah, I'm
just gives it more health. Okay.
There are 2 gorges there, so.
Alright, let's go sneak peek. Let's just build a hive. We don't need to fight them. Crag shade. Crag then shade. You can even drop turbine hive right now too, and you can still build it. And you have full advantage.
Oh, that aggressive, huh?
Yeah, you have full advantage here. Sure. They're not gonna do anything to smell me.
Hey, do we have 3 dive?
Yeah, I'm gonna go build it. Sneaky, come with me. Let's go build this real quick.
This is silly.
They're not threatening our res at all.
Where do you want the other tunnel?
What you do is just make a triangle between all 3 hives, you know? Make it nice and easy. That's the safest option. It gives us the most mobility around the map, and they can respond to any attack. We don't really need offensive tunnels. Like 99% of the game we don't. You just need to connect to hives most of the time.
I think the tunnels are sweet though.
They are, but you know, once you connect to all three hives, they can't really attack any of them without anyone being able to like spawn and go right to it.
Oh no, I agree totally, yeah. But they're fun though.
They're pressuring smelting in here.
Yeah, but they won't be able to take it yet. Third hive is up. See, like, if there was a tunnel between turbine and smelting, I could just go right back to...
Or it's smelting.
Get bile, please.
Does bile hit armor or no?
Yeah, bile's gonna,
bile takes out armor, but no health, unless it's an exo, which is only armor. And then you kill it.
It's so crazy about his armor. Immediately.
It was like that in NS1 as well, like fire does damage armor.
What? Are you serious?
Yeah.
Are you super serious? I didn't know that ever.
Yeah.
Fire damages armor.
Oh my god, you're kidding? That's why it's effective against buildings.
Yep, it's effective against buildings,
but it
helps
against armor too.
I'm pretty sure you can kill a heavy armor suit with bile.
Heal.
I don't think that's true.
Yeah, the HAs. We can still play MS1. I just played the other day. I put the video up on YouTube.
Blitz.
I'm pretty sure I used to play with you on MS1. Of course, I haven't played MS1 in 10 years.
You probably did. I played like 3,000 hours.
Probably should have played like 10,000 hours.
Yeah, I know. It didn't really count. Like, when it was just the World Opponent Network and Lava Steam, like... I don't even know like how I would have counted those hours.
I mean, I played for 10 years. So.
Yeah, me too. Actually, I played for like 12 years, because I stopped around like 2013.
Played from 2000? Let me think about it. It came out in like 2007, I think.
No, it came out in 2002.
I stopped playing in like... Oh, that's right, 2002, sorry. It came out in 2002. I started the first thing about that. I stopped playing and there's like one third of the 10 people playing.
I just played it the other day, a couple times. Been on bail.
I mean, I stopped playing video games entirely until like about a month ago.
Why would you ever do this?
Yo, bro, you should get like, you should get some
I had to play the laptop,
down,
damn it.
Oh yeah, there you go.
I got a little bit different thing around. It's totally different, I got shield things.
Yeah. Yeah, it's unplayable if your frame rate's like 15 FPS.
Well, you know how it is. You're like, alright, you see pretty well, you're running around, and all of a sudden a marine enters the battlefield, and you're like, wait, where, I'm dead. Oh, okay, that was fun, I guess.
Yeah, it has to be responsive and playable. Can you get shells, spurs, veils? Or just get the upgrades, the chambers?
Yeah, those are coming.
Not that we really need them, but...
They're pushing smelting kind of well.
Yeah, but I'm biling them. None of them have armor now. They don't even know what to do with this.
I'll keep saying.
They're dying to whips. Hydras.
Yeah, I want to test this now. I want like someone to bomb on me so I can see how much armor I lose.
It's a DOT, also like once it starts hitting you, then even when you're not getting hit with bile again, it's still like chopping away at the armor.
I swear it didn't work like that in this one. Maybe I'm wrong.
Buildings, it definitely gets rid of them.
Buildings, definitely, no. That's the whole point of getting bile bombs. Like, if you got two hives, you got bile bombs, you bile bombs, like that.
And I also got rid of, like, sieges, obviously.
Yeah, sieges too, of course. Any structure would damage
any structure. I'm pretty sure you could kill HAs with
it. Armor I never heard about. Really?
I mean, we could test it. I could just...
Yeah, I'm just curious. How do you download it anyway?
They updated, so after there was an update to Half-Life, there's actually a Discord channel for NS1. We still play Gathers, so, like, competitive 66.
That's the only thing is that I'm definitely not that skillful. Like, I can't comment.
No, most of the people there hadn't played for years, so it's, like, kind of goofy how it's not really competitive. It's a competitive format, but people aren't that good. Some are, but not really. It's a big skill.
When I stopped playing, it got to the point, like, that's why my favorite part of NS2 so far has been the team auto balance. By far, the best feature.
Yeah, well, with Gathers, the teams are picked. Like, you vote on a captain, and the captain's picked. Once they know what your skill is, then it kind of balances out, you know, as they go back and forth.
And what would happen is that we play like a game, like 6 or 8, the 2 or 3 best guys are all on one team, and it would never be a non-game, that would happen in like 3 hours.
Yeah, it would switch sides every time, it'd be like Marines one side stack, Aliens one side stack, Marines one side stack.
It was still fun, but it's just that like, kind of fucking great to end up with that game.
Well, I personally think that having a rank is also really fun. Like having an objective, like trying to win games because it like gives you an increased score or rank.
I really don't care about the kind of shit game. Because even though it like you know you're heavily involved, you know the game rewards you to get resources and build high and do stuff with the team. It comes down to skill too.
I mean, at the end of the day, that's what makes, you know, one or two players in NS really make a difference for a team. Because, like, the game is super complex, but if you know what you're doing, you can really, like, you know, go for the jugular. If you have the mechanical skill.
I mean, you talked about last week, was it 2 games ago? We were on Eclipse, or it was? We won because you had a 4-1 kill ratio or something like that. That's all we won. Like, now, it wasn't just because you used that, we had a win. It wasn't like you carried the team only because you had a good kill ratio, but that was the reason we won.
Yeah, well, that and I was going to the right places at the right time, doing the right damage.
Oh yeah, I'm not saying that you were just like blindly, you weren't just running to the hive, killing eggs, and like getting killed, I'm just saying, but, you know, if you had been an average player, doing the same thing, and now it's a little different for you, you would have probably.
But that's why my hive skill is what it is.
Yeah, well, that's why your hive skill is super high, right? That's why it's fun, that you're not like, always, you know, on the back key, right? You'd be like, that's fun.
Yeah.
That's what NS1 was like, to me, and towards the end, it was like, you know, it'd be one of you, another one of you, and like another one, like a hat guy almost as you, and they'll be the same team. And you can see it would be like, it's like this game.
In NS1, I remember learning like different people's names to stack, you know? Like, that's what people did. It's like you knew just based on how good people were, you're like, okay, so and so's on the ball team.
But you haven't started perfect yet. Because I like what happened.
Stomp
or whatever. I'm gonna stomp people.
No, hold J. You'll see that we're at 5 biomass. We gotta get up to 8. It's cost some time and resources.
Roger that. Nice for the chasing.
I'm working on that.
He's only gonna die.
Yeah, right? I almost lost my egg.
Everyone's going on as well. I feel bad.
Oh, he's here.
do is just get, what's it called?
Umbra?
No, that la- yeah, whatever. But the real upgrade that, that always Marines can see that when you gas their base, whatever it's called.
Spores? Contaminate?
Well, is it the lurk gas?
No, it's the one where you drop it in their base.
Oh yeah, that's contaminated. Yeah, you gotta get to 10 biomass for that. That's, once you get contaminated, it's almost always a win. Right then and there.
So let's say you just get it, so I wanted to get it in this game.
You don't actually need it to win. Need healing gorges.
You can build more hives.
Yeah, you can build as many hives as there are on the map.
I didn't know that.
Smelting doesn't have an RT, by the way.
Oh yeah, right. Thank you.
And
see, that's the problem with vampires and monos. You literally have to go all the way back to the yellow. Pop's about to finish, but with regen I can just sit here and heal right next to me.
Aw, damn it, no.
Kills and most of them were with the gorge, I think. Same, no, never mind, I only got three with the gorge. Crazy. Well, guys, check out my videos on YouTube. I've got playlists for Lurk, Fade, Monos, Skulk, Marine, Commanders, so you can check out different games if you want to see like meta or like how to like the different maps. You know, like what to attack.
What's the NS1 thing?